Good evening, everyone. I have another JVC cassette deck to show you this evening. But before I do that, follow up to yesterday's video. The cassette deck, the KD-10, I listened to everybody's advice, followed everybody's advice, and I now have a working cassette deck. It's lovely. And here, it was mechanical. It was the record play button. When I got home from work this evening, I took contact spray and I gave it a good dousing. And inside the unit around the play and record area. And then I worked at it for another minute or so, and all is well. I'm so thankful for that. Thankful for all the advice that you gave to me. It's the power of the internet. The power of the internet. You can save hundreds or thousands of 78 records from a record store in Long Island. You can topple Egyptian dictatorships, and you can save a JVC cassette deck. All these wonderful things due to the friendship of the internet. And I'll play a little bit here for you. Sweet. It might need a belt. The belt might be a little bit loose, but it does play, and all is well. Thank you once again. I'll show you a couple of things in the top here. I don't know whether people have seen these or not, but this one here is a realistic tape control center. You can connect three tape decks, or really CD players, using it as a central switch, basically. And you can have multiple units connected to one amplifier or receiver. The one next to it here is an Akai. It has, you can attach four decks, tape decks or CD players to this. So potentially you could have four tape decks and three CD players. You could have seven tape decks. You can have many permutations connected to one amplifier or receiver. You just need one of these accessories. And I don't know if they make these anymore. I assume that they do. I know they don't make this Akai one anymore. But they're very handy to have if you have multiple peripherals that you want to attach to your receiver or your amplifier. Fantastic things to have. The next JVC cassette deck is the KD-A5, and this one is from 1979. I think this is the model year after the KD-10, and it's a different design, and this one is a better model. It's definitely higher up in the chain. I don't know if it's top of the line one or not, but it is a nice one. It's got lots of features. It's very heavy. It's very, very heavy inside. It's a steel plate in the bottom. It's pretty amazing, actually. And this unit, when I bought it, it was pretty dirty. It had been ridden hard and put away wet. I had to do a lot of cleaning to get this one even to look nice. And the tape heads do show wear, which is not something I'm thrilled about, but it does play. It sounds fairly good, and it plays well, and so far so good. The display, the VU meters are beautiful. They're really nice. Green and red. They're all working wonderfully. Next to it we have the input level, big dial. Then we have the headphones, microphone, input select for microphone or line in, record mute. Then we have the ANRS, Automatic Noise Reduction System. It's kind of a Dolby on the JVC stuff. So it's on, off, on, and super. Tape select, high bias, ferrochromium, or SR normal. We have metal and chromium dioxide. Output level, which is really nice to have on a cassette deck, to have an outlook or an output level dial as well. Looking at the tape transport, it's a soft touch buttons on the bottom with some like LEDs or whatever they are there. They're all working. Power switch, timer standby, eject button, counter, and there's a little tape on the top there. It says metal tape compatible. And having a look inside, it was dirty in here. And I've done as good a cleanup as I can do. But it's quite a full chassis in here. And like Dr. Cassette mentioned, to repair JVC stuff, to try to take out this cassette transport would be a bit of work. It's fairly complicated. I'll hit the play button. There's the output. For those of you that might not be up on the latest, you know, cassette is the new vinyl. It's all analog. Hope you enjoyed this evening. Thanks for watching.